Hi guys, it's me, Olivia. I know that it's been a while since I've had an upload. As some of you may have known, I actually just got back from a trip to Dallas, Texas. Excuse my dog in the background. I've also got my cat in here somewhere. They're just kind of like, they're happy that I'm home. So anyway, as I was saying, I just had a trip to Dallas. I went to a concert and I also got to visit with two of my friends. One actually flew in from North Carolina, which is where I live. We both live in North Carolina. She lives about 4 hours away from me, but anyway, we both flew in from North Carolina to Texas for this concert to see, it's my friend now. I mean, I introduced them, but my friend in Texas who went with us as well. Anyways, we absolutely had a blast, and I'm sorry, I'm kind of like shaking with my camera a little bit, so I apologize for that. So that's why I haven't had any uploaded videos. I haven't done any painting because I was in Dallas this past weekend, and then for the past, about 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks or something like that since my last upload, I've been kind of dealing with personal things here at home and then also preparing for this concert and for this weekend that just passed. I was super, super excited. Like the whole month of April, I was like, I couldn't really think of anything else, couldn't really focus on anything else because I was so excited. That's not an excuse not to upload really, but kind of was for me anyway. Also, by the way, if my voice sounds kind of raspy, it is from all the screaming that I did this past Saturday at the concert. I screamed my head off, like, you know, to the songs and everything. I screamed my head off. So anyway, I thought instead of doing an art vlog, or not vlog, an art video, that I would do kind of like a vlog of sorts, to show you the pictures and stuff that I took from my trip. Me and my friends went to a couple of art museums. We went to the Dallas Museum of Art, we went to the Crow Collection of Asian Art, and then we also went to the Samurai Museum while we were there. And I do have a couple of photos from the concert. This is before the band was actually up on stage. And then there's like one or two photos that was after the band had left off stage. Excuse me. The band had left off stage. They went backstage, I guess, to prepare the encore. The reason that there's no pictures during the concert, which I would have loved to have shared pictures of that or even video of that with you guys, is because the band is from Japan, and they request, even in Japan, you know, not to record them while they are performing. And it's because their desire is for you to have like a memory that's, you know, it's something that you'll always have with you in your heart, you know. I'm not saying that there wasn't people who were recording it, kind of, we won't go into that, but anyway, they had asked not to record, and so I, you know, out of respect and, you know, and an admiration for the band, I didn't record any of it. I didn't photograph anything that happened during the live. It was strictly before and after, when they were not on stage at all. And I will show some pictures of me with my friends as well. So yeah, I figured that maybe I would do kind of like a vlog of sorts, to kind of show you guys what I've been up to this past weekend, you know, show you the different art that I took pictures of, show you a little bit from the concert, show you the Samurai Museum, and that's about it. I hopefully will have another strictly art video of me painting here shortly. I did, while I was there, have inspiration or have an idea for a painting while I was there. So I'm going to try to give that a whirl. Hopefully we can make it work on camera. Hopefully I don't screw it up while I'm recording it. I'm part of me is debating to do it off camera, but then I'm like, no, I should do it on camera because I haven't posted anything art-wise. Sorry, brain fart. Let's see. I think that's actually it right now. So this is my awkwardly recorded intro to this vlog-ish video. There is a 15-20 second recording that I did do while I was in the Dallas Museum that I will share. That's about the only recorded bit that I do have. The rest is pictures. So hopefully you guys enjoy and you enjoy seeing the art. I'll show the hotel. Like I said, I'll show the hotel we were in. I'll show the hotel, the art museums, the samurai collection, a little bit from the concert, and the pictures that were taken around Dallas while I was there. So I hope you all enjoy, and I will see you next video. All right, so the start of my trip was in Houston, Texas, because that's actually where I flew in. That's where I met my friend Breezy, and that's also where Katie, my other friend, flew in. This is where we met prior to going to Dallas, because Breezy lives in Houston. So I only got one picture from the this mural that was in the airport. I actually didn't get any other pictures of the Houston airport, mainly because we didn't really spend a lot of time in the, we spent a lot of time in the airport, but we didn't spend a lot of time in Houston. We literally left Houston as soon as Katie touched down and went straight to Dallas. And then from Dallas, we went straight to Houston and got on our flights to come back home. Anyway, I thought this was absolutely stunning mural. I had to take a picture of it. There was a lot of other things around the airport too that I probably could have taken pictures of, but I just didn't for whatever reason. I guess it was mainly because I was trying not to worry about pulling out my phone to take pictures. Because I actually took a picture of this at the end of my trip. I had seen it because it was near my gate and thought I would take a picture of it. But yeah, so this mural, I love the colors in it. So I thought I would share this with you guys because it's so pretty. All right, so when we got to Dallas, we went straight for the hotel that I had booked prior to the trip. And while I'm not going to divulge any names of where we were, and I'm not going to state, you know, the location of this hotel, all I have to say is this hotel was not what we were expecting. I was expecting something really, really simple but nice for the price that I paid for it. And when we got in there, it literally looked like one of those hotels that you would see on TV that's like a drug hotel. Like, I'm not even kidding. Like, the girls and I were like, we're staying in a drug hotel. Like, there's no telling what happened in this hotel. Honestly, it looked like one of those hotels that, you know, murders had taken place in. It was just absolutely disgusting. Basically, in the end, we decided we could not stay here. It was not inhabitable. The chair was falling apart. Well, the chairs, I should say, were falling apart. In fact, we all three were afraid that if we sat in them, we would fall through them. You know, a dresser was missing a drawer and it was chipped. There was pubic hair on the toilet seat. There was rusted bars where you hang up your clothes. There was an electrical cord that was like loosely taped up that just totally looked unsafe. There probably was more stains on the bed than what I captured, but we had spotted a stain when we pulled back the cover that literally looked like someone had stepped on the bed to maybe fix the picture above it and left a footprint on the bed sheet and didn't even didn't want to clean it. It was very, very uninhabitable. And I know I'm tripping over my words, but it was disgusting. It was not a good experience at all in that hotel. Not at all. We were panicking because we didn't know if we would be able to find something else, you know, that was close enough to the venue for the concert. It was just bad. And again, we were pressed for time, pressed you know, there's so many hotels that were already sold out, and luckily we did get to find one that was a little bit above the price range, but we made it work. So, but yes, like just look at this. I don't know how they are even okay with this. This is not what I had seen online when I booked. Like, what I saw online was totally more appealing than what we actually got. This is just absolutely disgusting, and I don't know how they are even still open, to be honest with you. Or at least I don't understand why they would have given this room to somebody knowing the state that it was in. I literally think the cleanest thing in this entire hotel room was perhaps the bathtub. And I even joked with one of my friends saying, well, if this is what we would have had to stay in, we would have just all had to bunk in the bathtub. Literally. So, just, again, I'm not going to divulge any names or any locations, but this is definitely not a location I would ever have anybody go to. All right, so as I was saying, we did have to find a new hotel, and luckily we got this absolutely gorgeous hotel, which I will give the name of. It's called The Element. I believe it's called The Element. It's in downtown Dallas. I think it's Element Dallas Downtown East or something like that. I think if you're specifically looking it up, I absolutely 100% recommend them. The guy that helped us check in when we got there that night, or that day, I should say, that afternoon, he was absolutely a gem. Like, I couldn't have asked for better service in my entire life. He even covered our parking because we'd had so much trouble with our previous hotel experience, you know, the one that we had just left to come there to. And he obviously knew that we were, you know, we were stressed and in need of, you know, somewhere to stay, because we were literally even thinking about just staying in a car, staying in Breezy's car, and finding some kind of free parking so that we wouldn't get in trouble and just kind of, like, you know, stay around in the car. Like, we literally even thought about doing that. If there wasn't any hotels available, and we got lucky. He even upgraded the room free of charge, because we were originally in a room that was with a king size bed and only one bed, only one king size bed. So he actually gave us the room with two beds, for the same price as a room with just one king-size bed. It was absolutely amazing. Again, The Element. So if you're ever in Dallas and need a place to stay, please go there. They're fantastic. And see, this is the view from the hotel. We actually were able to walk to a lot of the places that we went. There's a 7-Eleven nearby. There's a little cheap grocery store nearby. There's some eating, like, eateries, like sub places and all that nearby, so it's pretty close to some things that you can walk to. We definitely didn't have to always go in her car, Breezy's car. And then they have a second floor has breakfast, which is absolutely delicious. Also health friendly if you're really, really health conscious. They do serve things that are more healthy, like whole wheat pancakes, and they have a yogurt bar that you build your own yogurt. They have, like, egg frittatas and chicken, what was it, chicken sausage. It was delicious. All right, and here's just some pictures of me and my friends. Well, this is me and my friend Breezy, just kind of chilling out in the hotel. Again, it was absolutely amazing. I would 10 out of 10 go back. We actually plan to go back here if we ever go back to Dallas anytime soon. So definitely check out The Element. Again, as I said before, I 100% recommend it for everyone. So, and this is my friend Katie. Yes, I did get both of their permissions to put pictures in here and everything. And then in the foyer, this painting absolutely gives me life. I love this painting so much. I definitely wanted to share this with you guys because it reminds me of the artwork that I do. So yeah. All right, so as I said before, the original reason for going to Dallas is for a concert. We actually went to see the Gazette, who performed at the Bomb Factory. in downtown Los Angeles. Oh my gosh, one of the best experiences of my life. I have been wanting to see this band perform live for like 15 years, ever since I first got into them, which was literally like at the beginning, you know, of their existence. So this was actually really, really meaningful for me, you know, considering that, you know, they're who I listened to throughout, you know, my teenagehood, basically. And I absolutely adore all of them. As I said before, I created pieces of artwork for two of the members of this band who I really, really felt deserved a painting from me. So, and it was fun also going with Breezy and with Katie. We absolutely had a lot of fun. I would 100% again do it again. In fact, we've been wanting it to replay again because we had so much fun. And again, that's why my voice is so like the way that it is. It's kind of raspy, a little, you know, more than normal. So, and again, if you ever want to check out a different band, you know, something that's different, again, they're a Japanese rock band, but I definitely recommend The Gazette. Absolutely love them. Would recommend them to anybody. So definitely check them out if you're into international music and rock music, of course, or just, you know, into all different kinds of music. So again, had so much fun. Even got to meet a new friend, all three of us, while we were there. So it was fun.
Hello everyone. I don't know if you can hear me. Hopefully you can. I'm trying to keep quiet because I'm in an art museum, but I thought since I haven't really had time to do actual paintings, that I would kind of share with you guys a little bit of my trip to Dallas. Me and my friends are going to a couple museums, so I thought I would share that with you. And it's gonna be probably pictures instead of video, so, but I hope you guys enjoy. Alright, that's all I have for this video. I hope you guys have enjoyed my little trip. Again, I'm sorry that there isn't more video recorded stuff, and it's mostly pictures, but still, pictures speak 1,000 words just as well as videos. And of course, make sure you hit the like button, comment down below, subscribe button, and hit notifications if you want to see more content from me. Next video will be of a painting. So until then, guys, I hope you have a good one. See you next video. All right, bye.